Welcome you to the Big Fat Mixed Media Tribe, and in today's episode we will make Christmas gift tags. Very, very traditional Christmas gift tags inspired by these tiny designer papers by Decor, which is a Polish company. These little cards are ideal for making tags, just the right size, and the designs are absolutely gorgeous. And I'm going through them and picking out the cards which have more green and red pictures. These are not specifically Christmas cards. These are cards depicting vintage toys, beautiful on their own. And I chose some that have red cars and nutcrackers, which go well with the Christmas theme. And I will be using the Christmas night papers from scrap mail, and I'm choosing the papers which have smaller patterns. And I will also be using this page which has patterns in lines. I want the tags to be really traditional, so I'm using very traditional red and green papers. But the base of my tags I will cut from the craft cardstock, and I'm just using one of my slightly bigger cutting dies. I think this one comes from Crealis, to cut the base for my dies. And I will be working in twos, so I will be making two tags at the same time for the reasons that will become apparent a little bit later. So the decorative top layer of the tag I will cut from the pattern paper, and since I'm making shaker tags, I need to cut a window, so I found a rectangle die which fits inside my tag die, and I'm cutting them both at the same time to get a window in my top layer, in the decorative layer of my tag. And to raise the decorative layer so that I have room for the shaker elements, I'm using this foam sheet. And this is a very ordinary 3mm foam sheet that comes from the school supplies. But I find working with foam sheets so much easier than with foam tape. And the end result is more, accurate, more neat. And most importantly, I will not be able to see the tape from the side when I'm looking at the side of my tags. And of course I'm cutting little rectangles from the transparency so that we can see what's inside our shaker tag. So our little cards are just a tiny sliver too big, so I will be trimming off one or two centimeters from one side of my cards. So the cutting is done, but I will keep my cutting tool on the table because we will need it a little bit later. So all the main elements for the tags are cut, so let's put them together. Before that, if you cut decorative paper, you know that it has this white edge. So I am slightly brushing my paper against brown. I don't know if you can see the difference, but in real life it makes a big difference. If you cannot see the white edge of paper, it makes your whatever you are making look more professional. So now it is time to glue everything together. So the first layer is our beautiful vintage toy card, which goes on the base. And I am using God glitter glue. I could probably get away with using an ordinary white glue because I'm gluing just paper to paper, but still I tend to use this glue everywhere and for everything because it is very, very reliable. And I'm working these tags one by one, covering one tag just to press it a little bit while the glue sets. So the second layer is to glue our foam sheet, let's call it this way, foam layer, and see how easy it is to do. Since I'm using a liquid glue, I can just a little bit move the foam around, especially on the sides of the tag where we have just a thin line of the foam, and get a very precise result. So that all layers of my tag are exactly the same size. So the next step would be to fill our shaker, but I forgot it and I'm already starting to glue on my transparency layer. I decided to leave this part in the video because nobody is perfect, and I also I make mistakes, and then it's just a matter of correcting them. So I realized that I forgot to fill in my shaker. I took the transparency off. Again, the beauty of working with liquid glue, which allows you to remove what you've just glued. And I'm filling my shaker with these beautiful glass beads. They are tiny and they are much heavier than plastic beads, so they make beautiful noise, rattling noise inside of your shaker. So now I have to put the glue back again, and I'm taking care and putting just the tiniest amount of glue, because when I glue transparency, I have learned it that the plastic makes the glue spread, and it's very difficult to keep things neat when the glue spreads like mad, taints your work. So I'm doing the same. Yes, Dita, do not forget the filling. And for this tag I will be using these little paillettes. They are plastic, so they are not as heavy as the glass beads, but they are this beautiful antique white color. I find them beautiful, so I decided to use them in my tags. And again, the tiniest amount of glue and the layer of transparency sealing in the shaker elements. And let's return to the first card again and let the glue for the second tag to set. Did I say card? For the tag. And now let's work with the decorative layer, and now it will become apparent why I'm working with two tags at the same time. Of course, I could glue the decorative layer on top just so, but I like to complicate things. So I've decided to make each tag from two decorative papers, and so that I don't have any problems with matching the papers and they are right for the size of the tag, I'll cut two decorative layers at the same time. This way I can swap the top parts and the bottom parts, and I know that they will fit perfectly on the tag. So I will use a red bottom part and green top part, and again I'm gluing this decorative paper to the plastic transparency. So again, tiniest amount of paper, amount of glue, just to make sure that everything is clean and tidy. And the top part from other paper. And I think that it's already looking gorgeous and Christmassy. And there is something about combination of green and yellow that makes me happy. The same on the other tag, and it's beautiful as it is, but of course we need to add some more decorations. So here is the stripes, remember, from the stripy pattern paper, which had just additional element. And then I went through my box of Christmas ephemera, where I basically collect everything that I come across which has reds and greens in it. Quite a lot of it is from Tim Holtz ephemera packs also, but mainly these elements, just for these traditional tags, need to be green and red, and then everything goes together. and I'm just gluing it using the same art glitter glue on the bottom part of my tags. You can also, of course, cut out smaller elements from the decorative papers. And the last thing left is to add the eyelets and the ribbons. I happen to have these beautiful dark red eyelets, which work wonderfully for these Christmas tags. They add another element, and aren't they just gorgeous? So all that's left to do is to add the ribbons. And we have our beautiful traditional Christmas tags, and here they are all together with ribbons threaded. Please feel inspired to go and create your own Christmas tags. And I see you soon in the next episode, when we will create something wonderful and magical and beautiful. Bye bye!